Hello everyone, today my presentation topic is diet in gestational diabetes. Gestational diabetes occurs when your body has difficulty keeping your blood glucose levels within a particular range during pregnancy. Before you are pregnant, a hormone called insulin will have kept your blood glucose levels well controlled. During gestational diabetes, the insulin does not work as well as it should and levels of blood glucose rise. This type of diabetes usually goes away after the baby is born. Gestational diabetes is usually tested for between 24 to 28 weeks of pregnancy. At this stage, your baby's organs are well developed. He or she will be doing most of their growing until they are born. If your blood glucose levels are raised, any extra glucose will be passed on to your baby across the placenta. This extra glucose in your body can make your baby grow large around its stomach and shoulders, which can lead to difficulties during delivery. Having high glucose levels is also known to increase the risk of other complications. Keeping your blood glucose levels controlled is very important to help reduce the risk to your baby. Why gestational diabetes mellitus? Gestational diabetes is more common in women with a history of diabetes in their family. It is also seen more often in women of South Asian origin and women that are overweight. Having gestational diabetes during pregnancy puts you at a higher risk of developing it again in future pregnancies. We also know women that have gestational diabetes are at a greater risk of developing type 2 diabetes later in life. Diagnosis. Most people are diagnosed by having an oral glucose tolerance test. This is when you have a fasting blood glucose test followed by the taking of a sugary, that is glucose drink, and then a further blood glucose test after 2 hours. This will tell us how your body is managing the level of glucose in your blood both before and after drinking glucose. In gestational diabetes, many women find that the second blood glucose test result is higher, which means that your body had difficulty controlling your blood glucose levels after having a glucose drink. If you have found this, making some changes to your food choices and lifestyle can help to keep your blood glucose levels within the recommended target range of less than 7 millimole per liter. Food choices with gestational diabetes. If you have found out that you have gestational diabetes, making small changes to your lifestyle can help you to keep your blood glucose levels well controlled. During pregnancy, it is especially important to follow a healthy eating plan by having foods from a variety of food groups, that is carbohydrate, fruit and vegetables, proteins and some fat. However, there is only one group of foods that directly affects blood glucose levels. These are carbohydrate containing food. There are two main forms of carbohydrate, sugary and starchy. Under sugary, fruit juice, sugar, sweets, chocolates, biscuits, milk, yogurt, sugary drinks. Starchy, bread, rice, potato, pasta, noodles, samosa, kachoris, etc. Replace sugar in drinks such as tea and coffee with an artificial sweetener, for example Splenda, Kendrel, Sweetex. Avoid full sugar drinks, try diet or no added sugar varieties. Instead of ordinary cola, choose diet or sugar free. Instead of full sugar cordial, choose no added sugar varieties. Avoid large quantities of fruit juice. Try to limit yourself to one small glass of unsweetened fruit juice per day with food. Avoid large quantities of sweets, biscuits, cakes and chocolate. If you want some, have a small portion and monitor the effect it has on your glucose level. Fruit does contain natural sugar, however, it also has many other health benefits. It is advisable to have 2 to 3 portions of fruit per day. Add 2 to 3 portions of vegetables to make up your 5 a day. Try to keep portion sizes to 1 handful and spread your food intake over the day. Yogurts contain both added sugar and natural sugar. If you are trying to reduce the effect on your blood glucose levels, then you could choose diet or light yogurts. Milk contains some natural sugar, so can have an effect on blood glucose levels. It is also a good source of protein and calcium, so it is important to include some of this in your diet. However, if you have glucose readings above target more than 7 millimole per liter, 2 hours after eating your meal and you have not had anything sugary, it is important to think about the amount of starchy carbohydrate you had at your last meal. Did you have a bigger portion of carbohydrate than usual? Could you make a small reduction to the amount of carbohydrate the next time you have the same meal? Example of changing carbohydrate portions at a meal. You had a full plate of chapatis, rice and curry for your evening meal and your blood glucose levels were above 7 millimole per liter 2 hours later. To prevent this from happening again, you could try having less rice or fewer chapatis the next time you have the same meal. This would reduce the total amount of starchy carbohydrate at the meal and will help you to lower blood glucose level following the meal. When reducing the amount of starchy carbohydrate, this can sometimes make you feel hungry later on. Try to fill up on extra vegetables or salad with your meal if this is the case. Or you may wish to have a small carbohydrate based snack later in the day so the distribution of carbohydrate is more evenly spread.